What's up, everybody? I'm the one, the only Jack Slater. Yeah, you know this. What the score is, man. Comic Outlaw. Check us out, man. Smash that button. Meanwhile, we're doing She-Hulk 24, The Savage She-Hulk, The Day the Earth Screamed. Yeah, this issue and one more, y'all, wraps up this original She-Hulk series that started back in the 80s. And we're going to see how this wraps up right now. She-Hulk has been dealing with this lab who's been making these different creatures over time. And this guy has been pulling the strings, this mafioso. And finally, Jennifer has tracked him down. And she's ready to lay down the wrath, the rage of the savage She-Hulk. And Jennifer pretty much is at a breaking point. She feels that everyone has betrayed her. From her boyfriend Zapper to Jennifer's boyfriend Rory, since she was dating both of them for some reason. Her father and basically everything else. And not to mention this, she has the mafia after her that have been building different creatures over time. Different weapons, such. And now, she's found their lair as she falls into a hole. Now these two guys are having a discussion on what exactly they're going to do with She-Hulk. And how they're actually going to stop her. But he has a new weapon up his sleeve. A new ultimate weapon that he's going to use to destroy the She-Hulk. And they're kind of having a debate right now on whether or not they should just kill her or take her genetics. You know, whether or not she's valuable enough to keep alive and experiment on, or should they just kill and examine the body. Meanwhile, She-Hulk has fallen down into a deep pit, and she finds herself lost in the catacombs of this large, large area under the house, where all these freaks, genetic misfits, attack her. And they begin swarming around her, and She-Hulk has basically no other choice but to punch her way out of it. And she begins doing just that, you know. She begins knocking them back. She begins trying to knock them out. And these creatures do have some kind of sentience. But all of a sudden, out of nowhere, comes a little boy. And this little boy looks harmless. She even thinks back to the days when Zapper was her neighbor and used to get picked on. Yes, Jennifer and Zapper have known each other this whole time. And yet she felt obligated to cheat on him with Rory. Or, you know, Jennifer was dating Rory and she was dating Zapper and blah, blah, blah. But you get what I'm saying. Anyways, a little kid has psychic powers and he hits her with a beam that just makes her feel all the collective pain of her life. Everything that she's been through has just been amped up to the fullest and she's feeling all of it now. Meanwhile, Jennifer's father discovers that his girlfriend has been pushing Jennifer and him apart. She's been kind of plotting, you know, in order to take the house, take everything. And finally, he finds a note that Jennifer wrote that she tore up. And, you know, she's going in full denial, you know. Some women have an ability to just make themselves the victim, no matter how much shit they do to people. And this is one of those situations here. And Jen's dad is getting ready to walk out, you know, and he's really having doubts, and he's starting to believe what Zapper and Rory told him a few issues back, that Jennifer is She-Hulk. Meanwhile, this guy's working, tinkering, and these creatures come out of nowhere and just pull him away. And now there's a man with a gun there. He was actually planning to assassinate him, and like I said, these creatures just took care of him, and bink! That thing just ricochets right off. And this guy is so engrossed in what he's doing, and he didn't even pay attention. Now, She-Hulk notices that this kid has some kind of antenna on the top of his head, and she tries to reach for it, but he hits her again, blasting her with a nice psychic rush of pain and suffering. And then you find out this child actually should be named Damien, because he's just letting it go. He controls all these creatures. He's the jailer, basically, and he tells her that she's never getting out. Meanwhile, the scientist is getting ready to dump out his ultimate toy, his ultimate plaything. The culmination of all these freaks and experiments. As he puts this helmet on and pushes a button, he becomes the very earth itself. And as the earth starts to scream and screech, moving about to this man's will, a hand comes out of nowhere and grabs She-Hulk and tries to crush her as She-Hulk fights back, trying to resist. But no, the hand pulls her up through the cave, and this creature, this culmination of man, machine, and earth, calls himself Earth Lord. And he has She-Hulk in his grasp as he begins to crush her. And this is very interesting here, you know. And of course, Zapper is thinking back, you know, how he was happy with She-Hulk, you know, and they had problems, and then he sort of betrayed her by taking her to UCLA, and then they tried kidnapping her and experimenting on her. I never knew UCLA had that kind of equipment, but hey. And of course, there's Guy on Couch, Rory, the biggest idiot of this whole show. And they're kind of having a discussion right now, and they're both quote unquote here for Jennifer. But Jennifer's dad has other plans. He summons them in, and he wants to know the full story. He's ready to listen. He's ready to hear how his daughter became the Savage She-Hulk. Meanwhile, She-Hulk's kind of fighting off this Earth Lord, but he can control the ground, the trees, everything on the Earth. And the kid's just kind of sitting there watching, supervising, and he decides to join in the fray for the Earth Lord, just that kid's master. And he begins striking out at She-Hulk as a hand tries to grab her again. And this is where She-Hulk kind of jumps off and grabs the antenna and pulls it off, where the monsters warn her that the antenna was keeping that kid's powers in check. It kept a restraint on him that is now gone. And now, without the inhibitor, the boy feels nothing but pain. As She-Hulk and the Earth Lord and these freaks begin to square off, and She-Hulk is trapped in the middle. And what will she do as this kid's influence spreads out, spreading pain everywhere in one big psychic flash? The world screams all together for one moment as the Earth Lord sits there, a living mountain, as all these creatures and experiments begin to fall to the wayside, some of them turning back to normal, some of them being broken apart. But will She-Hulk be able to destroy the Earth Lord? Will she be able to stop this fiendish plot once and for all? We'll find out the next time, won't we? And I'll catch you on the flip side.